Leo and Danny show.
These immortal animals are tripping me out.
Yeah, you see, there's a jellyfish that'll live forever. It just keeps regenerating.
It'll live forever?
Apparently, unless like you crush it, unless it dies in some kind of blunt force trauma.
It's like an elf from the Lord of the Rings.
It keeps, yeah, when it's getting older, it regenerates and becomes young again and just keeps going.
I need to marry a jellyfish like that.
Would you want to be immortal if you had the opportunity? Because I like that in Troy when Achilles says, the gods, they envy us because we are mortal, you know, and every moment is so beautiful. So do you think you'd want to just be immortal and just bang 18-year-olds forever? You know that has something to do with it. You'd want to be immortal to bang 18-year-olds
forever. If you're Muslim, you can do that in heaven.
Dude, it's true. It's so hard to know where my head would be at if I was immortal. And it's interesting that quote you just brought up about the gods, they envy us because we're mortal. Mm-hmm. I was reading a book recently. It's called Stillness is the Key by Ryan Holiday. And he talks about how millionaires and rich people in cities, from his experience, they all tend to envy the simple Midwestern guy who works 9 to 5. Mm-hmm. While the simple Midwestern 9 to 5 factory worker, you know, he envies the dude on the coast with the beach house.
Of course.
Everybody envies everybody. Mm-hmm. And so often I see my friends who get off work at 4:30 p.m. on Friday, plop down on the couch, light up a blunt and watch a ball game. Mm-hmm. And I just think, fuck, man. Sometimes I wish I was
simple
that guy.
Life. Yeah.
But then you know they see us having sold out live shows or catching mm-hmm. a plane to Cleveland or to Arizona mm-hmm. or Texas. And they're like, fuck, I wish I was Danny.
Yeah.
You make these like wealthy elite friends and then you feel constantly pushed to keep furthering your lifestyle when you could easily just cut back your work and chill in a $300,000 home and Kansas or whatever for the rest of your life. Mm-hmm. But then I don't know, they get caught in that cycle.
Well, then my wife might cheat on me with a fucking good looking gardener. All right, so I gotta keep moving up, dude.
Or just fuck 18-year-olds for the rest of your life.
Well,
it's a healthy motivation.
Yeah, dude. Okay, so for real though, like, think about it. If you had to really make a choice, if some of the devil came down and you could be immortal, you're gonna see everybody you know die. You're going to have a lot of time to work on your channel. I'll tell you that much.
I don't even think I would care.
You wouldn't.
Who knows how your motivations would change? If you won the lottery today mm-hmm. and you had $65 million in your bank account, mm-hmm. or if the same happened to me, it is so hard to know what I would do the next day.
I know exactly what I would do the next day.
What would you do the next day?
I'd put $1 million into the Leo and Danny movie, dude. Feature film. I would get distribution rights and we would do a movie. I would love to see our fans all over the nation go into theaters to watch the Leo and Danny movie.
Okay. Do I have to write it?
I would hire you, Danny. I'd pay you well.
You do.
Yes, you do have to write it. I would help you write it. I would be there to, you know, every now and then be like, it'd be cool if somebody showed a cock. It'd be cool if we drew a penis somewhere.
Hey, somebody's got to make out around
page
85.
Someone's got to make out. You know, I'd be like, oh, it'd be cool if we beat the shit out of Fangoria there, though. I think if we could, we shove something up Fangoria's ass.
Rat Dick Ralph's got to come in at the start of the second
Rat
act.
Rat Dick Ralph. Oh, absolutely. Dude, can you imagine the movie, dude? Oh, my God.
There would be
the best movie of all time.
There would be a bunch of superfluous scenes where Leo gets his dick sucked in a parking lot. And they would end up all getting cut from the film, but he would insist they be in there.
Oh, I would be like, no, we're putting those in there. No, absolutely, dude. I'd give all my friends little cameos, you know, like fucking all the guys that you fucked over.
But seriously, if you mm-hmm. had $65 million mm-hmm. in the short term, that month after you acquired the $65 million, what would you do?
I mean, I'd you know, despite my father, I'd probably like fucking, I'd buy him a house for him and my mom to enjoy. Maybe like, give my sister some kind of menial job. My older sister who's struggles, she hates her job. So I'd give her some kind of, I'd start a foundation for a big write-off, give her a job, and maybe my other sister, both of them, instantly try to fix my family. Probably wouldn't work anyway. My dad'd still call me a pussy. Then I would then work on the movie and you would have to write it.
Do you get what I'm asking?
Yeah,
I'm asking
it,
about motivation.
Yeah. There'd be no motivation. I would be less, you know, I would be less likely to do anything productive for a while. Yeah,
absolutely. Mm-hmm. If I had $65 million, there's got to be a period where I'm in Vegas. Mm-hmm. Everybody I know and like is in Vegas with me mm-hmm. and we're not sober for a week. Mm-hmm. That's happening. Houses are being purchased. And eventually, absolutely, we're coming back to comedy. But I don't know. Would I have the motivation to work 13 hours a day, 6 days a week? I might scale back a little bit, huh? If I had 65
absolutely.
Million.
I think the only guy that doesn't is like what? Like Floyd Mayweather, Elon Musk, fucking... There's some guys that are crazy, man.
Arnold. There are a lot of people. Tom Brady doesn't scale back an iota.
Not even a little bit.
Bill Belichick, his former coach.
Yeah.
A lot of people in the NFL or pro sports or in music are still working just as hard,
right?
Even though they're rich.
Right.
So that it's not saying that the second you become rich, you're going to lose all motivation. You still might. But I wonder what that would do to me. And if I were immortal, this is a strange thought exercise. Mm. I don't fucking know. Would I just lie around in bed?
I mean, everything would no longer be as beautiful. Like sex, for example, you could have sex forever. It's not, you're going to be young or whatever age you decide to be when you're immortal or whatever choice you get, or if there's a choice. But then would having sex with a beautiful woman even be that interesting anymore? Would food, you're going to eat the best steaks forever?
Are we assuming you're rich? How do you know you're gonna get the best steaks?
Maybe not the best. What if you're poor? For I mean, you could eventually get rich if you're immortal. You could just start saving if you're fucking,
that's true.
Even if you're making $15 an hour, you save them for fucking 45 years.
You could get a birthday card from your grandmother, mm-hmm. put it into the stock market, and mm-hmm. just wait it out until that was $1 billion.
Exactly.
Wow. We got that problem taken care of.
Yeah, seriously.
You could take over the world at that point.
You could maybe take over the world. Yeah, if you can't die, you probably would lead countries. You'd have so much experience. God, I don't think life would be that good. I think you'd be doing heroin.
Yeah. I mean, if you're immortal, why not be fucked up on heroin all the time?
I mean, it works for everybody else.
But I don't know. I think a lot of the pleasure we get in life comes from working toward goals that are going to pay off in our short lifetime. And if we just blow the roof off and there's an infinite time frame, I don't know what goal setting looks like starting a family and putting your kids through college and having a nice retirement for you and your wife. I don't know. That's traditional shit people work for, and it goes away.